Our guest of honor this evening is the former manager of the Giants, Cubs, and Reds, during which time he won 3 National League Manager of the Year awards. He enjoyed an outstanding 19-year Major League career playing for the Braves, Dodgers, Giants, and A's. He was a 2-time All-Star, the 1977 NLCS Most Valuable Player, a winner of the 1981 Gold Glove Award,
and World Series,
and a 2-time Silver Slugger Award winner. He won a World Series title with the Dodgers in 1981. Here to honor the legacy of Jackie Robinson, please give a warm welcome to Dusty Baker.
Thank you.
Good evening, everyone. It's a great pleasure and a tremendous honor to be here tonight. Jackie Robinson meant a lot, you know, in my family. My dad used to always tell me whenever I was going to get in a fight or whenever I felt some kind of injustice to, you know, what would Jackie do? And, you know, for a kid that went to high school my last couple years, well, first, my dad just always remind me that I was born in 1949, the same year Jackie Robinson, you know, was a Rookie of the Year. And for a kid that moved to Sacramento when there were only 2 blacks in my high school, me and my brother, and times were still a little tough at that time, went to the South. You know, the faith that I was taught by my dad, the fact that my parents were civil rights, you know, movement people. You know, Jackie Robinson actually was at the forefront of the civil rights movement at that time. Not only was he a great baseball player, he was also a good student. Then, you know, our lives have paralleled in quite a few ways. And then I was in the military, and Jackie Robinson was also in the military. To meet his family, to hear the stories about Jackie Robinson when I was with the Dodgers, to rub shoulders and listen to the stories, you know, by Don Newcomb and Roy Campanella and, you know, Joe Black and Jim Gilliam and all the guys. I felt like I knew him, and it really helped me a lot. And I just want to say thank you very much. And
ladies and gentlemen, at this time, we call your attention to the area near our scoreboard to honor the remarkable life and lasting contributions that Jackie Robinson made to baseball, civil rights, and American history. The San Rafael Pacifics hereby formally retire Jackie's number 42.
Welcome back, everybody. Top of the third inning here in this 8-1 ball game. Falentini to lead things off against Guerra, the second pitcher of the night for the Pacifics. Lentini, who is 1-for-2 on the night with a strikeout, has a stolen base and a run scored. Pretty productive so far. We're just in the third inning. Takes a fastball across the knees, taking 2-1. To my right is our first junior broadcaster of the night, part of CMCM. And the Pacifics Association, a little outreach to get young people involved in broadcasting, as lifted very high as Lentini, fouled first base line into Jane's First Base Cafe, and somehow it misses everybody. And this is my friend Graham. We'll call Graham Double G tonight. How's it going there, Double G?
I'm doing pretty good, Stu. How about you?
I'm doing well. Thank you very much. And how are you liking the experience so far working with CMCM and yours truly and the Pacifics?
I mean, it's a great experience to get out there and do this. I mean, this is what I want to do with my life, so it's nice to try it.
That's very well said. Falentini stands back in 2-2. Double G going to be a big-time broadcaster with ESPN or somebody. I know there are scouts here tonight. Here's a chopper first baseline. Going to be a very tough play. Diving in head first. Falentini slides in. He's safe. Covering on the play, Garrett couldn't get there fast enough as Chavez had a tweener there, Grim, and he just tried to underhand it to the covering Guerra, and Lentini dove in head first. He's saved with a base hit.
That was a little Gregor Blanco-esque right there, Stu. I mean, he just full-out dove into first base.
He really did. That's an all-or-nothing type of play. And, you know, they argue that diving in is not the fastest way to get there, but I'll tell you, it causes confusion, if nothing else. That's what I like about the head-first slide.
Oh, yeah.
Sergio Miranda now stands in with Lentini, the runner at first base. The fastball is very high to the left-handed batting Miranda. And you can see to the my right. There's Graham right there. Look into that camera. One ball on Miranda, who stands in now, the 2-9-3 batting two-hole hitter. He fouls one third baseline, giving chase is Gingras. Coming over is Martinez. He just in front of the scoreboard. Can't get to it. And it's just a dramatic strike, 1-1. Jared Mochizuki is on deck. On the evening, Miranda was hit by a pitch back in the first inning and a run scored there. A hit to left field in the second and a run scored. Miranda's been a big part of this 8-1 offense. 8 runs on 7 hits for the Stompers, and we're only in the third inning. Still nobody out. Breaking ball is down low, taken 2-1. Miranda, 13 RBIs and a stolen bag on the season. Lentini, the runner at first base. Very high, 3-1. Nice warm night here down downtown San Rafael at Albert Park. This park has been here a long time, open 65 years. Lentini goes, a long fly ball to left field. Pace to his right, backing up is Williams. He's got it. And there's one away.
Now batting for Sonoma.
So Sergio Miranda goes down, one away. Lentini has to retreat back to first base. Looked like a hit and run there, didn't it, Graham?
Yes, dude, that was a design play, and it didn't work out there good for the Stompers.
Almost, as Miranda got a good piece of it. Here's Jared Mochizuki. Mochizuki struck out looking back in the first. Check swing, taken ball one. Then he walked in the second inning, and a run scored. As part of that 8-1 onslaught. A quick step off by Guerra. Guerra, the right-hander, has come in relief of Wander Barris, who had a rough start tonight for the Pacifics. Hard-throwing Barris. Everybody really talking about him all day today. Fastball is taken by Mochizuki, 1-1.
Looks like Guerra's really finding his groove now, Stu.
Yeah, it was a nice pitch there. Pacifics just have one run tonight after the big bomb by Matt Chavez. Curveball is down low, taken. 2-1. The slugger, Joel Carranza, is on deck. Jeremy Williams in left with Zach Pace in center and Michael Hoba in right. Martinez at third, Gonzalez at short, Kiriakos at second, and Chavez at first. Snap throw down to first after a fastball is up and away. It's 3-1. Diving back in is Faelantini. One away here in the top of the third inning in this 8-1 ballgame. Pacifics have a lot of work to do tonight, Double G.
Yes, they do, Stu. It's going to be a long night.
It could be. Runner goes. Foul down the third base line on Anderson Drive. Mochizuki has run the count full. Kind of tough to follow these guys because everybody's wearing the number 42. It's Jackie Robinson night. So usually, you know, as an announcer, as you know, we follow the numbers of the jerseys. But everybody's 42. Carranza's on deck. Mochizuki stands in. Lentini goes. First base line. It's two hopped over to Chavez. Lentini was going all the way. Chavez just steps on the bag. And there are two away. Lentini over to second base.
Looks like another hit and run play there.
Yeah, you're absolutely right.
Now batting for Sonoma.
So they're going to call that a fielder's choice for those Carranza of you scoring at home. And here's Joel Carranza. Carranza won. Let's see. He's one for one on the night. He walked. He has a pair of runs scored. hard shot into left field back in the first inning with an RBI. Two down here in the top of the third inning. Stuart Horn and Double G, a breaking ball is in the dirt. Carranza takes. 1-0. Now, I've been told that Dusty Baker's going to be on with us at some point tonight. I hope so. Dusty's going to be signing autographs through the end of this inning. So then maybe we'll get him after that. Isaac Wenrick is on deck. Carranza takes upstairs, 2-0. A fastball from Guerra. Guerra, the big right-hander. First year with a squad. First year as a Pacific, I should say. Carranza, a 323 hitter with five bombs. Swings at a high fastball, 2-1. Of course, Ricky Gingras is behind the plate right now for San Rafael. Gingras, a first-year man with San Rafael, has been an incredible addition to the team. Lentini takes a huge lead from second. This is a line shot up the middle. A 360 spin move from Danny Gonzalez. Unbelievable throw. He got him.
What a play there, Stu. That is just phenomenal.
That defensive play was brought to you by First Federal Bank of San Rafael.
That was phenomenal, man. You are absolutely right. And on the play, Danny Gonzalez with that 360 spinner from behind the bag. And it was all the way in center field. Saved a run for the Pacifics. Clearly, at least just the run and the hit. And the score remains 8-1. We'll go to the bottom of the third inning. And coming up for San Rafael will be the 8-9-1 hitters in Martinez, David Kiriakos, and Zach Pace will send it down to the field for Malena right now on our Spanish update.
Estuve bueno en esta entrada los Pacifics la verdad que se salvaron y estamos en un total de para los Stompers 8 carreras con 7 hits y para los Pacifics seguimos con una carrera y un hit con un error, entonces esperamos que esta segunda mitad de la entrada sea muy provechosa para los Pacifics. Vamos a un corte.
Baseball is a beautiful thing, just a wonderful thing. It's 8-1 here in the bottom of the third inning. Martinez first at bat of the night. Man, seems like we've been out here a while. A fastball is taken for a ball. Martinez here in the bottom of the third inning, batting .234 with one home run and seven RBIs. Jeff Conley, the big left-hander, still out on the mound, delivers a breaking ball. 1-1.
It's a bit hard to believe it's only the bottom of the third inning right now, Stu.
Yeah, this 8-1 game. So the Pacifics have only had seven batters so far, while the Stompers have had 23. So eight runs and seven hits, and that's why it's such a lopsided affair so far, 2-1 to Martinez. Third baseman for San Rafael, Martinez, lifts one to right field. Hibbert circles under. Hibbert's there.
Now that for your position.
Adrian Martinez,
second baseman.
The pop fly to right field, and Hibbert.
Well, Matt Chavez has been the Pacific's only offense tonight, too.
Yeah, that bomb that he hit in the first inning, the bottom of the first inning, he hit quarter to 370.
He's got a very
4 years. Graham, and I've only seen two home runs. That was the second one over
your
that sign.
Please, I need JD
and buckles
Shane,
back from a
Nico
fastball
and Alex,
the ball on
Pacific's first base dugout.
Yeah, he's
area
got a smooth stroke.
Musical chairs.
It's just beautiful.
It really is. It's funny when you see the smoothness and the power come together.
Once again,
see you later.
JD
fastball
Shane,
is
Nico,
very high,
Alex.
2-0.
To the Pacific's first base dugout area,
please. 306, 19 RBIs and a pair of stolen bags. Conley walks off the hill and rubs up the baseball. Kiriakos his second year with San Rafael. And a fastball across the knees is taken. 1-2. Zach Pace is on deck. One away here in the bottom of the third. Ooh, I thought it caught the outside part of the plate. But maybe it was a little bit low as well. And now it's 2-2. Well, I don't know. What's going on with the scoreboard? Scoreboard says 3-1.
Hey, are you walking?
And he was correct, and it's a walk. And Kiriakos is only the second,
now
check it, third base runner of
sponsored by Alton Construction
tonight for the center field.
Center fielder, the Zach Attack.
And here's Zach Pace. One away. Pace is second at bat of the night. And if anybody can spark a rally, Zach Pace. 268 hitter. Chopped one over to first base back in the first inning. Picked up by Baptiste and underhanded to the covering Conley back then for the first out of the bottom of the first. Pace stands in, 11 RBIs and a single home run. Fastball is upstairs. A little wide, 1-0. Johnny Bukakis is on deck, and now a mound visit from Ricky Jingers. From Isaac Winrich. That's the second time I did it. Well, it's night number one on the air.
Yeah, the only way to tell the two teams apart is the pants, Stu. It's
I'm
difficult.
I'm telling you, it is tough with these numbers the way they are. Everybody is number 42 in celebration of Jackie Robinson night, which is cool to have Dusty Baker here and retire 42. That part I like. It's fouled back to the screen now as Zach with a big swing. 1-1. Pace, who's been a part of the Pacifics organization since its inception back in 2012. Had an amazing year last year as the MVP of the league. Graham, as you probably know, he had no errors in 144 tries out in center field last year. Isn't that amazing?
That
he takes
is,
down
yeah.
low, 2-1. And when you consider center field here with the wind and the dust and the opposing softball diamond, to go 144 times with no errors is really something. And of course this season, and the Pacifics this season are only 24 games in, this is the 25th game of the season, no errors so far. Zach starts every night, taking low 3-1.
That is the deepest part of the yard, Stu, and that's a lot of ground to cover. So
that's absolutely right. Pace, who has a master's degree in kinesiology from Sonoma State, takes ball four. And now the runners have consecutive The Pacifics have consecutive
now
runners on walks.
Pacifics designated hitter, Johnny Bukakis.
Well, let's see if they can get something going here, Stu. I mean, got to get some more runs than just that lone run from Matt Chavez.
Yeah, they're going to need a little more than just one, considering it's 8-1 at this point. But the Pacifics are tough. Now, here's an interesting stat for you, Graham. The Stompers are averaging 7.3 runs a game. So they're already up to 8 tonight. So they are an offensive powerhouse, and the Pacifics are going to have to deal with that every time they play them this season. And they've already shown it tonight, obviously. This 8-run first two innings for the Stompers is not an anomaly. It's right at their average, frankly. 1-1 to Bukakis. Matt Chavez, who has the bomb earlier for the Pacifics and the only run scored tonight, is on deck. Breaking ball is stroked in the left field. That gets down in front of Hurley. Coming around third to score is David Kiriakos. Over to third is Zach Pace. The throw
Johnny
in from
B.
left. And Bukakis slides in safely with a double and an RBI. It's 8-2.
Seems like he's really put a spark into the offense, Stu. I mean, let's see if they can get something going for him tonight.
That's exactly right. The Pacifics need a little spark. Very well said, Double G. An RBI double in the left for Bakakis. And now the Pacifics with just one out have runners at second and third. Pace over at third. Here is Matt Chavez, who hit one 490 miles back in the first inning, maybe further. Takes a fastball up and away for Chavez, 1-0. Mikel Hoba's on deck. So Jeff Conley on the mound for the Stompers has the 3-4-5 batters to contend with right now. He looks through the webbing of his glove. Chavez, a check swing and a big breaking ball, 2-0. And now Chavez ahead in the count. And with each pitch, Conley digs himself a tiny bit deeper. Chavez, a 303 batter with 10 bombs, 27 RBIs. He'd get two more here with a base hit. Chavez from the right side. The left-handed Conley comes inside. Ball three. 3-0 now to Chavez. And Jeff Conley takes a long walk around the pitcher's mound. Climbs back up on the hill. 3-0. The first huge moment of the game. Here it is. Fastball taken all the way. 3-1. Chavez was going to let Conley make the mistake there with Mikel Hoba on deck. Chavez in the dirty walked him. Bases loaded for the gentle Cuban, Mikel Hoba. Last time up, Hoba hit into a 5-3 put away. Interesting about Hoba though, he had a 37-game hitting streak back in 2012 when he was the MVP of the league and the Pacifics won the championship that year. Had a 17-game hitting streak, check it, a 7-game hitting streak earlier this season. Snapped and then came back the next night when he went 5-for-6. Hoba, one of the most capable hitters on the in the entire conference. Currently batting 366, that's the high number for the Pacifics. And if you look up and down the Pacific's hitting lineup for tonight, example, Grim, you got Pace at 268, Bakakis 280, Chavez 303, Hoba 366, Williams 291, Gonzalez
280, Jingles
310. All the Pacifics are right around 300. And now here's Hoba with the bases loaded and only one out, 8-2.
One swing of the bat here could put the Pacifics right back into the game, Stu.
And it's a fly ball to left field. Hurley's on his horse, he comes in. Zach Pace will challenge him. Oh, and Pace holds up. He tims all the way down the third base line. Nobody was covering third, and a perfect throw from Hurley in left field. Would have had Pace by a mile, two away.
Hoba just missed that one, Stu. That could have propelled the Pacifics.
Left fielder, Jeremy Williams.
Just missed it. Mikel Hoba, as Graham noted, he roped it. Hit it very hard. He just hit it right to Hurley. Didn't quite get under it enough to get that backspin power. Now two away. Bases remain loaded with two away. Here's Jeremy Williams. 291 batter Williams with four home runs and 14 RBIs. Two down. Williams is very capable of the long ball and a breaking ball. Ricky Gingras is on deck. But that 3-4-5 part of the lineup for the Pacifics is just brutal. And a line shot into right field that gets down a base hit. Coming in to score is Zach Pace. The long throw in from right field. Hibbert gets it in quickly, but not before. The Pacifics can get two in as Johnny Bukakis comes in right behind Zach Pace. 8-4, the Pacifics coming back here, Graham.
Now batting for your Pacifics.
Catcher Jeremy Williams
Ricky
delivers.
Gingras.
A single to right field. The third hit of the night for the San Rafaels. Matt Chavez over to third base. Runners at the corners. Here's Ricky Gingras. First pitch swinging to second. Scooped up by Miranda over to first. Baptista's there. And Gingras goes down on one pitch. 4-3. But in the half inning, on a couple of hits, the Pacifics pick up three runs, Graham. And now it's 8-4. And things are looking
all right,
much
fans,
better
it's time for musical chair sponsored by Roadside
coming
Barbecue.
Up in
Roadside serves authentic all-American
the top
barbecue
of the fourth
in the heart
inning.
Of Marin County.
For the visiting stompers will be Isaac Wendrick, Christian Gay-Gay, and Daniel Baptista. We'll go down to the field now for Milena in our Spanish, our new segment, the Spanish synopsis. And here she is, folks.
Y bueno, ahora estamos levemente recuperándonos los Pacifics con tres en esta entrada tenemos tres carreras. En dos hits, con un total de cuatro carreras en tres hits para los Pacifics. Y para los Sonoma todavía tenemos ocho carreras en siete hits. Para los Pacifics tenemos un error y los Sonoma sin errores. Así que bueno, veremos cómo continúa el partido en esta cuarta entrada. Nos vemos. Hasta el próximo. Hasta la próxima entrada.
And our two finalists. A questionable ending there, Sir Francis. Thanks to our contestants in Roadside Barbecue, Baseball and Barbecue. Is there anything better?
Welcome back, everybody, to downtown San Rafael. Well, it's 8-4, and the Pacifics are making it very interesting. It's a wonderful, baseball's a wonderful thing, isn't it, Jeff?
Oh, yeah. It's definitely a real good thing.
It really is. Isaac Wendrick is going to lead things off here in the field. And a long fly ball, and I mean it's deep, to center field. Zach Pace goes back to the wall. Pace, he can't come up with it. It drops out of his glove. Around second and on his way to third, Wendrick comes in, and I don't believe what I just saw. Pace had it right in his glove, and it popped out at the base of the wall. Are they going to call it an error?
I wouldn't call it an error. That would have been a heck of a play out there in center field if you were able to come up with it, bouncing off against the wall. Can't believe what you just saw. I don't think that was Kirk Gibson out there, was it?
Well, he hasn't had an error in about 9 years.
Wow.
And he didn't have a single error all last year. I was just talking about it in the last half inning.
Right. If he gets an error there, that would be a real rough
error. No. That was a long run. He was right at the base of the wall, and Wendrick is credited with a triple. Wow. Here's Christian Gay-Day. He's got Wendrick. He leads things off in the triple. Out there at third base. We're just here in the top of the fourth inning, 8-4 ball game. The Pacifics put three up.
And an interesting note here that as much damage as the stompers have done, that's one of the first extra base hits of the night. Most of their damage has been done just with singles.
Gay-Day stands in 1-1 with Baptiste on deck. Breaking ball is over to second base. It gets under the glove of Kiriakos. Kiriakos leaned down on it, and it just scooted right underneath it. I do not believe the last two plays. for one to pop out of the glove of Zach Pace. Now, oh, and they did give Pace an error. His first error in 2 years.
That's a rough error. I'm sorry, but that's a really rough error.
It popped right out of the webbing of his glove. I mean, it was in there. It was deep in his glove, and it just popped right out. Unless they're going to call that last play an error. I got to find out which it was. You know, it might be on Kiriakos.
Yeah, to me, there's no debate that the last play was absolutely an error, at least in my book.
Well, we'll find out if they're going to call that on Kiriakos or on the previous play on Zach Pace.
For what it's worth, in my book, I didn't even have hesitation. I just wrote down E4 for that last play for anybody scoring at home.
So Gay Day is aboard after the error by Kiriakos, and I think that's what it is. I think that second error came up for Kiriakos, not a late credit. So the triple stands for Wenrick, at least I'm assuming so. And here's a fly ball down the third baseline. And it's nothing and two. The count remains. Gay Day, the runner over at first base. One run in. A triple for Wenrick. Then the error brings him in. Oh! And a line drive foul ball, third base side. And I don't know how that missed that fan over there. There's a fan standing up, and I thought it was going to nail him in the forehead. It looks like he's okay, thankfully. It's 9-4, everybody.
Well, that was a major ugly finder right there.
Baptista stands in 0-2. After the ugly finder down the third base line. Here it is. Chopper off of his own shin. And Baptiste is still alive.
I mean, I thought it was going right into the bar down the left field line.
Yeah, yeah.
Like a little lounge. I thought it was going right in the window.
It did. It looked like it was going in. Fastball is a little bit away. And now it's 1-2. Well, it was nice to have Double G on the air with us. His very first appearance as part of the Pacifics and CMCM's attempts to cultivate young people and their aspirations at becoming broadcasters. Double A is coming up here in a couple innings. She's dying to come on the air. I can't wait to get her on.
Oh,
here's a chopper up the middle. It gets off of the glove of Guerra. And Gonzalez off balance across the diamond. Gets him. Are you kidding? That's another insane play by Gonzalez.
Wow. It looks like the pitcher kind of lost his balance coming off the mound. I think that's why it ended up going off his glove. But for Gonzalez to come up with a bare-hand off-balance play, that is a heck of a play. That's big. That's a big league play right there.
Absolutely. After it came off of Guerra's, it hit him in the hip or something. And then Gonzalez was able to come in, and here's Mark Hurley. Just one away. Gay Day moves over to second base on the play. A breaking ball is called strike one to Hurley. Hurley was the first batter to face Guerra tonight after Wander Barris left back in the third inning. Breaking ball and a broken bat up the middle. Diving forward into Gonzalez. He can't get to it. Zach Pace runs in and grabs it. And everybody's safe. So Hurley with a broken bat single. Straight away center field. Scoots Gay Day over to third base. And the Stompers just keep stomping. And they are squeezing the wine out of the Pacifics right now.
Yeah, but say it's... The Stompers, it's like October, middle of harvest for them, just stomping away.
Yeah, they are bringing it right now. They've got the Pacifics in a barrel. I don't know how many more these we can come up with, but Matt Hibbert is on his way to the batting area. Hibbert is 0-2 on the night with a strikeout and a ground out. He's got Mark Hurley over at first base. He's got Christian Gay Day at third. Guerra with a long look over to third and a chopper up the middle. Danny Gonzalez comes up with it, backhanded, on to second, on the way to first. Chavez with a great stretch and a double play. Hibbert goes down 6 to the covering 4-3, and Hibbert helps the Pacifics out there a little bit because they got Hurley as the second out and Hibbert officially the third out, and that'll move us to the bottom of the fourth inning.
And for a game that hasn't been the cleanest so far for the Pacifics, man, Gonzalez is putting on a show at shortstop. My goodness.
We'll send it down to Milena now for our Spanish synopsis right here, courtesy of CMCM. Take it away, Melina.
Hoy estamos acá en el partido de los Stompers contra los San Rafael Pacifics y tenemos ahora una gran mitad de entrada ahora para los San Rafael Pacifics, que lograron hacer dos grandes jugadas defensivas, pero igualmente los Stompers tienen un total de 9 carreras con 9 hits, pero bueno, también tuvimos, a pesar de estas jugadas defensivas, tenemos dos errores muy complicados y bueno, me están tapando la cámara, pero creo que igual mi mensaje se entenderá de que tenemos que vamos a poder dar vuelta a este partido si tenemos las ganas de hacerlo. Así que bueno, nos vamos ahora a un corte y este compañero acá de los Pacifics nos está dando un gran momento de partida acá y vamos al corte ahora sí.
Nice job,
Dennis. Nice job. All right, welcome back, everybody, to downtown.
Leading off for your second sponsor by Mercedes is yours, Danny Gonzalez.
Yes. Everybody to downtown San Rafael. Danny Gonzalez starts things off with a rope line drive into left field. And that'll bring up Adrian Martinez. It's my pleasure, everybody, to welcome in Double A, one of our new young broadcasters. Hi, Double A.
Hi.
I'm glad to have you with us. You've really been studying hard. There's Double A on the camera right there. Look in the camera and smile. Hey, everybody, get a chance to see Double A. She gets her first chance. This is her debut on CMCM television, broadcasting the Pacifics. Danny Gonzalez, the runner at second base, who opened up this, the bottom of the fourth inning of this 9-4 contest, with a double. And Adrian Martinez hammers one back to the screen. And the count is nothing and two. Well, Double A, you have a lot of experience with baseball, don't you?
Yeah, my family, they're really, really big Giants fans.
Yeah.
And we have a family member who I think is a season ticket holder.
All right. There's a breaking ball up high, and Adrian Martinez goes down on strikes for one away. Here's David Kiriakos. And you were in a Giants ad recently. You were featured in that ad. You're a professional actress, aren't you?
Yeah, I am.
That's pretty cool. And did you have a good experience? You were with the... Tell us about that. You appeared with who? Michael Morris?
Yeah, he's a former Giant. He's on the Marlins now.
And you were featured prominently in that ad, though there were other kids involved. You were the one who got the speaking line, right?
Yeah.
Yeah, I bet that was fun. David Kiriakos stands in, and a breaking ball is taken inside, 1-0. Danny Gonzalez, the runner down at second base. And now something off speed is very high, 2-0. Zach Pace is on deck. It's a 9-4 ball game. We're in the bottom of the fourth inning, everybody. Stuart Horn in Double A on CMCM's coverage of the 2015 Pacifics. Fastball is up and away, 3-0. And you've been working with me over the last few days. You and I have been doing some work on air, getting your broadcasting skills in order. And we're going to talk about that in a moment. Here's the next pitch. Two Kiriakos taken for a strike. And it says it's 2-1, although I must be off by one. I had it 3-1. And you like broadcasting.
Yeah, it's really fun to do this and to be a part of CMCM and the San Rafael Pacifics.
I agree with you there. It is fun. There's a big swing and a miss by Kiriakos. 2-2 count. Zach Pace is on deck. Look, runner back to second and fouled back to the screen. Oh, that came close to hitting our camera up there behind home plate. Just a dramatic strike there. The count remains 2-2 as you see the close-up of David Kiriakos. Kiriakos batting 306 with 19 RBIs and a pair of stolen bases so far this season. Second year man with San Rafael. Ropes one in a shallow right field. Coming in on it is Hibbert, but going out is the second baseman, Miranda, who made a really tough grab, double A, where it would have been an easier play for the right fielder.
Yeah, that would have been an easier play.
But as it turns out, Sergio Miranda was able to grab it out there, and there are two away. Here comes Zach Pace, a fan favorite. Pace, who walked back in the third inning, ultimately scored the second run of the four scored overall by the Pacifics tonight. Johnny Bukakis is on deck. Zach Pace from the left side takes a fastball up and away, 1-0. There's double A over to my right. She's here watching the game up here in the CMCM booth. 1-0 to Zach Pace. Johnny Bukakis awaits in the BMW on deck circle. Oh, very close, but taken by Pace, 2-0. Pace has 11 RBIs coming into tonight's action, 5 stolen bases. You know, last year, Pace is arguably the fastest guy in the league. And this is fouled down the third base line into the beer garden. 2-1. Double A and Double G, the two young broadcasters, are going to be with us for all 7 broadcasts this season. They're going to have a chance each game to come on for an inning or two and hone their skills on the microphone. You must be excited about that.
Yeah.
A foul ball by Zach Pace. It's 2-2.
Maybe Zach Pace could get a stolen base.
Well, he's got to get on base, but you're right, he has 5 so far. If he could get on base, I bet he would try to steal. And the breaking ball is in the dirt, and the count runs full. So Danny Gonzalez, who started things off here in the bottom of the fourth inning with a double, still stands out there at second base after Martinez struck out and Kiriakos with a fly ball to right could not advance it. Pace takes upstairs and he walked it. So as Double A mentioned, Pace now on first base.
Johnny Bukakis
may try to steal a base, but he's got to have
to. Wait, he does.
And as it turns out, Gonzalez is over there at second base. So Zach Pace is going to have to move Gonzalez along, I guess. Johnny Bukakis, who is 1-for-2 on the night with a double and an RBI. A run scored and he struck out back in the first inning. Takes a fastball, low and in. 1-0. Matt Chavez, the big slugger, is on deck. 9-4 ball game. 9 runs, 9 hits, no errors for the Stompers. This one's taken low and away by Bukakis. And now a mound visit by Isaac Wenrick. First time Wenrick's run out to the mound, double A.
Yeah, maybe he was doing that just to tell him to.
Yeah, what do you think? What do you think the catcher says to the pitcher when he runs out there?
To not worry about runs scored. If he throws some of his regular pitches, then it'll be okay.
Yeah, I bet you're right. Anything to calm him down, right?
Yeah.
I agree with you. Bukakis is back in there, 2-1. Line shot, third baseline. That's a fair ball. Bukakis over to first, coming in to score easily is Danny Gonzalez. Right behind him is Zach Pace on his horse. Pace comes in. And it's a ground rule double as Mark Hurley throws the hands up and asks for field umpire Mike Keller to run out for an official ground rule double. as it went under the fence out there in left field. So we'll see if Zach Pace's run is going to count. Certainly Danny Gonzalez's run will count. And a ground rule double has officially been called, which is going to move. Let's find out what's going to happen here. It looks like Bukakis will have to stop at second base. Matt Cavanaugh, who is the Pacifics manager, is arguing that Zach Pace should not have to go back to third base.
He made a call. He didn't even walk out there.
Pace minimally is going to be at third base. Certainly Danny Gonzalez is in. It's at least a 9-5 ball game. But Matt Cavanaugh, and I think Matt Cavanaugh, double A, has a legitimate argument. Because on a ground rule double like that, in this case, I believe Pace should have been awarded home plate. Hey, do you have an opinion on this?
He's going to get two right here, man.
Okay. All right. Matt Chavez with a chance to knock Pace in. He's got Bukakis at second, Pace at third base. Two away, 9-5 ball game. Ground rule double, Chavez, who has a walk and a home run.
Come Chavez.
Officially tonight, 10 home runs, a breaking ball is taken rolling away. One and out. Michael Hova's on deck. Pacifics fans are really trying to will Matt Chavez along, double A.
Yeah, Matt Chavez has 25 RBIs this season, and he could get another one right now.
Let's hope so. If you're a Pacifics fan, and I know you are, I know you're hoping for one. This is a breaking ball in the dirt to Chavez, 2-0. .303 batter is Chavez. The big slugger Chavez in the three hole with Hoba behind him. Two runners on, one runner in, two down, breaking ball. Good take, 3-0. This would be a nice time to get the bases loaded, wouldn't it, double A? Because Michael Hoba, the four-hole hitter, is coming up next.
Yeah, that would be a good idea to get the bases loaded.
See if he can do that. Chavez takes a fastball down low, but he gets the call. Does Conley, the pitcher, 3-1. Stuart Horn at double A with you right here at Albert Park. Chavez the batter. Here it is. Hammered to right field. That gets down a base hit. Hibbert moves it. Coming in to score is Zach Pace. Right behind him, and it's Bukakis. Around second on his way to third is Chavez. He had an inside the park over him last night. Triple tonight. Chavez clears the bases. Two more runs are in, it's 9-7. Pace and Bukakis both score on the play. And here's Michael Hova. Wow. How about that? Double A, Matt Chavez with a triple and two RBIs.
That's pretty good. Now they're only behind two runs. And with five innings left in this game, they could win the game.
You're right. Hoba could tie it right here with a single hit. Breaking ball is taken for a strike. Nothing and one on the gentle Cuban Michael Hoba. .366 batter, three home runs tonight, up and in. Hoba takes 1-1. 15 RBIs and a chance to get another one right here for Hoba. Jeremy Williams is on deck. 1-1, 9-7 now. Curveball is taken, 2-1. Hoba, eminently capable. Conley, who's really working quickly now, and Hoba reaches for one, fouled back in the parking lot, 2-2. Nine runs on nine hits for the Stomper, seven runs on six hits. and two errors for the Pacifics. Here's Conley, and Hoba fouls one back to the screen, a mighty hack. 2-2, we'll do it again. And I think most Pacifics fans in this situation would want Michael Hoba up. And Hoba drills one, third baseline. Oh, we almost hit a cop car. A police cruiser coming down Anderson Drive. And that's what all of the crowd saw it. A police cruiser was barely missed double A as Hoba hit a sharp line drive down the third baseline out on Anderson Drive and almost got one of our men in blue. Here's a hammered shot to shortstop. Picked up by Mochizuki, and Michael Hoba goes down 6 to the covering 3 to end things. But as it turns out, the Pacifics put 3 more up in this, the bottom of the 4th inning.
On your mark, get set, and go.
Muchas gracias, Stuy. Estamos acá en el final de la cuarta entrada en el partido entre los San Rafael Pacifics y los Sonoma Stompers. Y acá en la segunda parte de la entrada, los San Rafael Pacifics pudieron hacer una mejor actuación de lo que venían haciendo, logrando 3 carreras en 3 bateos. Muchas gracias al señor Matt Chávez, que hizo una gran actuación después de la pérdida de esa gran jugada que habíamos hecho antes, pero él logró entrar estas grandes carreras por nuestros jugadores, así que gracias a él estamos un poquito más cerca de alcanzar a los Stompers, que tienen 9 carreras en 9 hits. Nosotros seguimos teniendo 2 errores y este es el final de la cuarta entrada. Hace un poquito más de frío ahora, que estamos un poquito más de noche, pero bueno, vamos a seguir acá en el partido y ahora nos vamos a un corte.
Leading off the top of the 5th for Sonoma, Faye Lentini.
Well, the Pacifics are making this one interesting, though.
Yeah. Interesting fact, Hova's been with the Pacifics since their first season back in 2012.
Yeah, you're absolutely right. He was the MVP that year, in fact, and had a 37-game hitting streak in 2012. Faye Lentini is going to lead things off here in the 5th. And a high fly ball to right field. And Michael Hoba, as AA just mentioned, an interesting fact about Hoba, comes up with the grab, one away.
Sergio Miranda.
Here's Sergio Miranda. Miranda, who was hit by a pitch back in the first inning. A couple runs scored, a base hit in the second, and then a fly ball in the third. His 4th at-bat of the night.
Your attention, please.
And a fastball is taken. Ball one. 1-0.
First base dugout area for the hula hoop contest.
Double A is part of the CMCM and Pacifics outreach to young people who are working on a career in broadcasting, and she's alongside. Yours truly, Stuart Horn. There we are. Look in the camera there, Double A.
Pacifics first base dugout area.
She's doing a great job so far tonight. How old are you, Double A?
9.
You're only 9? Ow. You sound like you know what you're doing. And that's important. 2-0 now to Miranda. Got your dad along. He's here tonight. Here's the team photographer leaning in. Bentley Nelson on. Always a part of things. Here's a fastball now. And taken across the outside part of the plate to Miranda. 2-1. Miranda, left-handed batter. Batting 293 with 13 RBIs, a single stolen base with Mochizuki on deck. Taken with a fastball right. Wow, that was down the middle. And it looked like Miranda didn't like the call, but the count's full, Double A. Looked like he didn't like the call there.
Yeah, it looked like he didn't like the call. It did look like that.
I think you're right. Full count, back up the middle, over to his left, on the run. Is Gonzalez.
Fans would like to remind
and
you,
Miranda goes down, needs, 6-3.
We're super coach right outside the
two
game.
Away. Here's
please
Jared Mochizuki.
Use the players' bathroom.
Mochizuki, 234 batter with a pair of home runs. 25 RBIs. He struck now out looking back in the first inning with
Jared,
a walk and a run scored in the second.
Once again, Elias, Theo, and Kaden to the Pacific's first base dugout area, please.
We're in the top of the fifth inning, and now a late timeout is granted as home plate umpire Eric Thompson wants to talk to Faylantini, who's come out. And Faylantini is, as everybody can see, he's poking Eric Thompson in the chest, and he's kicking dust all over him, and he's walking away from him. And it looks like Faylantini has been tossed out of the ballgame, and he wants to get his money's worth. Faylantini, who is a player manager, is really angry, and I'm not sure if it's because Bach was called, but at this point in the ballgame, oh, the fans are loving it. Oh, Faylantini is picking up dust. Now you can see what he is really angry. He's covering up home plate with as much dirt as he can get. And the fans are loving it. And finally, Faylantini is going to leave the area. Nope, he's not ready to leave yet.
An interesting fact about Mochizuki, this is his first season with the Stompers.
So Mochizuki's the batter, and I don't know what the beef was.
Me neither.
It's a 9-7 ball game. That I know. But I'm not exactly sure what Faylantini was upset about.
The call?
But I know that he covered home plate with a ton of dirt. Do you know what he was mad about? The fans don't know either.
Fans, we believe that manager and center fielder Faylantini has been ejected by the umpire.
There you go. Lentini has been ejected. And, you know, Double A, that's a big deal because Lentini's a great hitter. He's an over 300 batter.
Now batting for Sonoma.
And he's got a run scored to hit tonight. And not only that, he's the manager of the team. And that's going to be really tough on the Stompers in a pretty close ball game. But he's gone now with two away.
I never saw him get ejected. I never saw the umpire do the ejected sign.
You're absolutely right. He didn't. He never actually gave him the you're tossed sign. But I think he's gone. Mochizuki's in there 1-1 here. We're in the fifth inning. But you're right. He never did the big you're out of here sign, did he?
No.
Kind of wanted to see that. Carranza's on deck as Mochizuki takes 2-1. Mochizuki with a walk and a run score. In a second.
Well, sometimes you get unexpected, funny, interesting things in baseball.
You're right. And a fly ball to center field gets down as Zach Pace moves over to his left. A perfect jump by Zach Pace, as usual. And that holds Jared Mochizuki to a single to center field. Joel Carranza's on deck. Hey, Charles Scott is here. Great San Rafael guy and big league ball player. He's behind us right now speculating at exactly why Faylantini was so mad. Nobody really knows. I guess Faylantini probably knows Double A.
Yeah, he probably knows the reason.
Faylantini wouldn't have been so mad if he didn't know.
What happened if he threw home plate out of the ballpark?
Well, I think home plate's tacked down, but he could have grabbed one of the other bases. Those come up, don't they?
Yeah, they do. What happened if he had thrown it at the ballpark?
Maybe we just have to use a t-shirt or something as a base. All right, we had a quick timeout there, but now Joel Carranza is in the batting area. He's got Jared Mochizuki over at first base. 9-7 still in this weird game that's had box and ejections and the manager create a sandcastle on top of home plate. And it's nothing and one to Carranza as Tony Guerra continues to throw hard.
Well, it's the perfect season to make a sandcastle.
Yeah, you're right. Summertime is a good time for sandcastles. Maybe that's what Lentini was doing, one and one to Carranza. Wenrick is on deck. Isaac Wenrick, that is. For now, it's Carranza. Takes one across the knees and a called strike, one ball. Two strikes on the big slugger, Joel Carranza. Pacific's getting some action going in their bullpen. And Carranza stands in, 1-2. Breaking ball, and it gets away from Gingras. And they're going to call it a wild pitch. Carranza, even in the count, 2-2, as Mochizuki goes down to second base. Double A is alongside yours truly, Stuart Horn. We're here in the fifth inning, a 9-7 ball game. Well, I will say this, Double A, it's fun to have a lot of runs scored in a ball game.
Yeah.
Sometimes a pitcher's duel is nice too, but you know, our first.
Yeah, like when the Giants are playing the Dodgers and Madison Bumgarner is up against Clayton Kershaw.
It's like that. All right, here we go. Go get him, Tom. Now that can be a great pitcher's duel, or some games are fun where there's just tons of home runs and tons of hits.
Yeah, like a team losing by 10 runs and then coming back with 15 runs in the third inning or something.
Yeah, something like that. 2-2 as Carranza waves at it. Carranza, the big slugger. Seems like he's been in there a while. The DH batting in the four hole as usual with Isaac Wenrick on deck. Carranza, 323 batter, five bombs. Here it is. In the dirt. Blocked beautifully by Gingras. Man, that was a tough block right there.
An interesting fact about Carranza, he was a 23rd round draft pick of the Tampa Bay Rays back in 2007.
All right, very good knowledge. Thank you. Excellent input there. Wenrick's on deck. Carranza has 16 RBIs coming into tonight's action. Scored twice so far tonight. Guerra, the right-hander, looks the runner back to second. 3-2 count. Fouled back to the screen. We'll do it again. Carranza. He's a big, burly guy. And just always has been a pain in the neck, the Pacifics.
Why?
Well, he always seems to hit the ball very hard. And he always seems to come up at the most inopportune time. In other words, he's such a good hitter, and it always seems like he's up with runners in scoring position, like he is right now. And here's a fly ball into right field. The line drive gets down. It's a fair ball. Coming in to score all the way from second base is Jared Mochizuki. And just like I said, Double A, that's exactly what I'm talking about. Carranza delivers a hard line drive into right field and gets an RBI.
That's not good, because if the Pacifics want to win, they really need to up their offense.
Well, it looks like they're going to have to up their offense. It's 10-7. Isaac Wenrick is due up next, but Matt Cavanaugh is on his way out to the mound. Cavanaugh, his first year as the Pacifics manager, though he's been with the squad for 3 years, he was the number one catcher the last couple of years, and now is the manager, no longer playing. And he's going to send Guerra to the showers for now, and a good job by Tony Guerra.
What happens if Lentini's due up for the Stompers?
Well, he will come up. He's already been up this inning. Lentini, but as you're talking, because he was thrown out, you mean, so obviously they'll have to be a pinch, a substitution, because Lentini's also the center fielder. So I don't know who's going to play center field, and that's a very good question.
Do the Stompers have any utility players?
In fact, they do have utility players, as you and I talked about. So that's a very good segue. Well, you're getting good at this.
Yeah, I guess I am.
Yes, you are. It's 10-7, everybody. And the Pacifics are going to send up a new pitcher. And we'll have that for you when we come back right here on CMCM's coverage of the 2015 Pacifics. Stay with us.
Your attention, please. Now pitching for your Pacifics, Chris Lovejoy. This call to the bullpen is brought to you by Verizon Wireless Click Away Mobile on 4th Street by City Square in downtown San Rafael. For local community service, choose Verizon Wireless Click Away Mobile. Fans, we want to remind you that the merchandise booth on the third base side of the stadium will close in the middle of the seventh inning. Take the opportunity now to head over there and grab some new Pacifics gear.
Welcome back, everybody. Chris Lovejoy will be back out on the mound for the Pacifics. Actually, not back out on the mound. He'll be out on the mound for the first time. He'll be facing Isaac Wenrick as his first batter, lefty on lefty. And they got to get the house music turned off before they can throw. Lovejoy was ready to go there, AA, but the house music was going.
Yeah.
And the home plate umpire had to tell him to turn the music off. Lovejoy, a big, tall, slender, hard-throwing lefty, opens up Wenrick with a strike. Wenrick on the evening has a couple of hits, including a triple, two-run score. Carranza, the runner over at first base. Oh, he absolutely blew one by Wenrick. Way behind him, 0-2.
Lovejoy's doing good. Pacifics and in minor league baseball.
All right, and what's making it that he's doing well? You were just saying he was doing really good. What any numbers in particular you want to mention?
His ERA 1.08, which is
very
pretty low.
Good. That's exactly what we needed to know. Good job. You look great there on the camera, by the way. That away. Isaac Wenrick stands in 1-2. And he takes, a fastball across the knees, a little bit low, 2-2. How many games has Lovejoy played, AA? That 1.08 ERA is pretty impressive.
He's nine games.
Well, there you go. That's pretty good work. And a fly ball, third base line, that's out of play.
And he's 1-3 and lost one.
So he's 3-1 with a 1.08. Those are impressive numbers. Lovejoy takes a long look in now to Gingras. Carranza's still the runner at first base with just a slight lead. No chance Carranza's going to run. Not a real fast guy. This is fouled back to the screen. Wenrick, sixth pitch of the at-bat coming up. 10-7. Every time the Pacifics come creeping back into the game, the Stompers throw a few more on them. Christian Gayday is on deck. Wenrick stands in. Curveball is lifted to center. Zach Pace can't get to it. It bounces right in front of him. And Wenrick is aboard with his third hit. He moves Carranza over to second base. And here comes Christian Gayday. That was a nice piece of hitting by Wenrick.
Yes, it was.
He just lifted it right there over the head of Danny Gonzalez's short, and it landed right in front of Zach Payson Center. This is Christian Gayday. Gayday reached back in the fourth in an error on Kyriakos. Couple hits earlier in the game and a run scored. Fly ball to right field. Hova comes in, holds up. He's got it. And Gayday goes down on a long fly ball to nine.
Interesting to know this is his first year of
the who, for Christian Gayday? Ah, well, thank you very much. That's good information. The Stompers score one more, and it's 10-7. Coming up for the Pacifics will be Jeremy Williams, Ricky Gingras, and Danny Gonzalez. Coming up on the play-by-play is my partner Jeff Safford, and back on the mic with Jeff will be Double G. Double A, you did a great job in your debut appearance. I just want to tell everybody how awesome you were. And we'll take it down to the field now for Molina.
Estamos acá en la quinta entrada del partido entre los Stompers y los Pacifics. Después de empezar la entrada con un pequeño incidente con el manager, ahora creo que me pueden ver, ¿no? Con el incidente entre el manager y del equipo de los Stompers, que también es el centro del campo de los Stompers, que terminó siendo sacado del partido. Pudimos continuar con la jugada, con la entrada que terminó con una corrida de los Stompers con tres hits, con un total de 10 carreras y de 12 hits para los Stompers, y nosotros seguimos obviamente con 7 carreras y 6 hits y 2 errores, que esperamos que sean mejores ahora en esta quinta entrada. Ahora vamos a un corte comercial y vamos a seguir en esta quinta entrada, que esperamos que sea muy buena para los Pacifics.
Your attention, please. I need Sherman, Kirby, Miles, and Dexter to the exact first base dugout area for the potato sack race. Jonah, Kirby, Miles, and Dexter to the Pacific's first base dugout area, please. Your attention, please. Now pitching our first runner, Eric Gonzalez.
Welcome back, everybody, to the broadcast of Pacifics Baseball here on Marin TV. This is Jeff Safford. We're here in the bottom of the fifth inning. San Rafael Pacifics are trailing by 3 runs. Jeremy Williams, a pinch hitter, will lead things off. Jeremy Williams, the number 5 hitter in the lineup, will lead things off here for the Pacifics. 5, 6, 7 hitters due up this inning as they look to keep fighting in this game, as they are way behind early, but they've clawed themselves to at least give themselves a chance here in the fifth. And the first pitch to Williams is upstairs and a little bit inside. Williams is 1-for-1. He singled in his last at-bat in the third. This pitch is inside, misses for ball, 2-0. Here on Williams, and definitely looking to just get some early base runners here in this inning to try to get a rally going. There's a strike, fastball on the inside corner. 2 balls and 1 strike. Williams, big, strong right-handed hitter, swings and he hits a high fly ball right center field. Should be playable, and it is, in right field by Matt Hibbert.
Well, Jeff, it looked like there was no coming back for the Pacifics. So they were down 8-1, and it looked like there was no hope. But they jumped right back into this ballgame, and now a three-run ballgame.
Catcher, Ricky Gingras.
And here is Ricky Gingras. Gingras is 0-2. He's hit into a double play and also grounded out to the second baseman in his last at-bat. Left-handed, digs in and takes a fastball in there on the outside corner. Strike one. Pretty nice night here at Albert Park. Jackie Robinson Day here at the ballpark. Lefty swings and fouls one. Looks like off the mask of the catcher, but looks like Gingras is doing just fine behind the plate. Walrich. Wrong roster. You always have to worry about that when a catcher gets hit right in the mask. You actually saw that with Buster Posey last night as the 1-0 pitch is up a little bit high, 2-1.
Yeah, that was a scary moment last night for the Giants.
Yeah, there was a play where Buster Posey got hit in the mask. Andrew Susak had to step in and finish the game for the Giants. Giants got swept by the Marlins. And there's a swing and a foul.
Your attention, please.
Back
now
over the top of the big visitor dugout.
T.J. Gavlik. Gavlik will bat in the leadoff spot.
There's the answer. T.J. Gavlik is playing in the place of Valentino, who is ejected.
And T.J. Gavlik, if you've heard the announcement, is came in for Centini, who was ejected in a very dramatic ejection. And that was good stuff. I always like to see a manager really get angry. I mean, obviously he's probably going to face a multiple game suspension now, but you always love to see it. 2-2 pitch, here it comes. Swing and a foul back onto Anderson Drive. Look out.
That was pretty entertaining, seeing him cover up home plate and get in the umpire's face right there, Jeff.
Oh, yeah. And with that foul ball, it reminded me of foul ball in the last inning. Almost hit a police squad car. That would have been real interesting. Swing and a miss there on the 2-2 delivery. And Gonzalez is gone. Or Gringas, excuse me, is gone.
Now batting Fair Pacific, sponsored by Crucialia Jewelers, Danny Gonzalez.
And now here is Danny Gonzalez. Gonzalez, fly it out to right. And also hit a ground rule double in his last at bat. So he's 1-2. Part of the rally in the fourth inning for the Pacifics that got them back in the game. 3-run rally. 0-1. Here's the pitch to him, and it's a little chopper foul down the third baseline out of play.
Yeah, Jeff, that ground rule double, just a shot hit down the left field line, just skipped underneath the fence and threw his hands up, and it turned into a ground rule double.
Yeah, there really isn't a lot of room here at Albert Park down the left field line. There's a fence that's right by where the stomper bullpen is. And if it goes under that fence, it's a ground rule double.
Good.
0-2 pitch is way outside. 1-2.
Yeah, that was pretty unfortunate for the Pacifics. Had to be held up at third base, and they couldn't score that run.
Here's the 1-2 pitch, and it's a swing and a grounder to third. Should be an easy play. Throws off balance, and they got him. Very nice play in what looked like was going to be a relatively easy play for Gay Day at third, but he ends up having to go off balance down the line a little bit. But the inning is over. Quiet inning for the Pacifics. We will head to the top of the sixth till a 10-7 deficit for the Pacific, and we are going to send it down to Milena for the Spanish wrap-up. Milena, take it away.
Muchas gracias, Jeff. Estamos acá de vuelta en el partido. Una entrada muy pobre para los Pacifics, pero bueno, ¿qué se le va a hacer? Vamos a volver a intentarlo en la entrada número 6 y nos encontraremos de vuelta acá y veremos qué nos traerá esta nueva entrada número 6. Vamos a un corte.
And there's our winner. Thanks to all of our participants. Fans, we just completed the Marshall Little Works Grand Slam meeting, and that was it.
We wish you all better luck next time. Leading off for the stoppers, Daniel Batista.
Welcome back to the broadcast, everybody. We're here in the top of the sixth. Pacifics still trailing 10-7. Lovejoy still on the mound for the Pacifics. Lovejoy fires a fastball, and it's outside, misses 1-0. Daniel Batista leading things off for the Stompers. Batista takes another one outside, 2-0. Batista is 1-for-3 this evening. He singled in his first at bat. One for two. Singled in his first at bat, walked in the second inning and grounded out to the shortstop in his last at bat. 3-0 the count on Batista. As the Stompers look to add on here in the sixth. Lovejoy's delivery is ball four outside is the call from home plate umpire. So Lovejoy walks the first batter of this inning on four pitches, Stompers, and Mark definitely not Burley. What the Pacifics were looking to do to start the sixth. So here's Mark Hurley. Hurley is 1-for-3. He singled his last at-bat in the fourth. And Hurley takes outside ball one. And now, catcher Gringas is going to come out and have a word with his hurler. Pacifics have fought their way back in the third and fourth inning. Two straight innings with three runs to get themselves back in it after the Stompers put up four runs on the board in both the first and second innings. 1-0 count, pitches on the way, misses. Looks like a two-seam fastball. 2-0 the count, and six straight balls here for. And Hurley, you'd have to imagine, would be taking all the way. And he is, and it's a strike on the outside corner. It has been a struggle for the pitchers for both teams here tonight. You can tell by how late it is, and we're only in the top of the sixth. That ball is swung and fouled back. Combined, we've had 17 runs on 18 hits. Two errors for the home Pacific team. No errors for the Stompers to this point. We've had a little bit of everything here tonight. Swing and a pop-up, foul ground, might be playable, and it is not, as it ends up against the backstop.
Yeah, high-scoring game here, and just 17 runs in less than six innings is pretty incredible.
And it's been a lot of loud contact as well. We saw the home run for the Pacifics, and just a lot of loud contact in general, just guys hitting the ball, using all the fields. It's been an offensive clinic here tonight. I think Jackie Robinson would enjoy it. Swing and a foul straight back to the screen. Actually, down the right field line a little bit, but 2-2 the count. Nobody out. Runner on first. Infield, a double play depth. Outfield playing straight away. Pitch is swung on and lined into right field, a base hit. Runner will not move up. However, Hurley is aboard for his second hit of the game. He is 2-for-3. Now here is Matt Hibbert.
Now batting for Sonoma, Matt Hibbert.
Hibbert, to this point, is 0-for-2. He's struck out, and he's hit into a 6-4-3 double play in his last at-bat in the fourth. And with two runners on and nobody out, what do you think the Pacifics need to do to help keep some runs off the board and keep themselves in this ballgame?
Well, I mean, a ground ball would be perfect right here. You can get a double play, and then you got two down.
Bunt is shown by Hibbert, and the ball rolls foul.
That bunt went foul, but it was brought to you by Nothing Bunt Cakes.
Well, they got to be careful with Matt Hibbert here. He's hitting 321 on the season, and just a dangerous hitter with a runner in scoring position.
He has a lot of speed. He's very fast base runner. That always comes into play here. He tried to get on earlier in the game with a bunt single, but bunted it just foul. 0-1 pitch on its way, breaking ball, well in the dirt. Good block there by Ringas behind the plate. And that's exactly what you don't need if you're the Pacifics. You got runners at first and second. You don't want to see two runners in scoring position right here. 1-1 the count. Here it comes. Fastball just misses off the corner. Maybe a hair high, do you think? Yep. Tough to say, I would. Two balls and one strike. Lovejoy sets at the belt, out of the stretch. Here it comes. Swing and a pop-up foul. Straight back behind us. Two balls and two strikes.
That are in attendance. Welcome, former Pacifics interns. And we'd like to point out that was the only year the Pacifics did not win the championship. Sorry, Tabor.
Funny comment made there by the PA announcer talking about some of the Pacific interns, and a little snide remark by the public address announcer. Was the only year Pacifics did not win the championship. Almost like a poke at the, it was the intern's fault. a little bit of fun here at the ballpark. Great atmosphere here at the yard at Albert Park. Should definitely make your way out to the ballpark. Full count pitches. Way up high and outside, ball four. No work in the Pacific bullpen, so this is Lovejoy's inning.
TJ Gaflin.
There's still nobody out.
Somebody just got up in the bullpen, and they're getting somebody up as quick as they can, seeing the bases loaded and no outs.
Well, it's been a walk, a hit, and another walk to start this inning. Stompers already up by three and looking to put this baby to bed here in the sixth inning with another big inning. As this pitch misses low to TJ Galvick. This is his first at bat of the game. He came in when Santini was ejected in that skirmish I talked about earlier. Takes this one for a strike. Lovejoy seems to take a breath of relief after that one. One ball and one strike is the count. Only one man up in the bullpen. It's a swing and a base hit right field. One run comes in to score easily, and they are going to hold the runner, and no, they will not, as they thought the run was throw was going to come to third, and it does not, which allows the second run to come in to score. So it is now 12-7.
Well, the ball booted by Mike Alhova in right field, and that's just unacceptable if the base is loaded. I mean, you just can't do that.
Yeah, the second he saw that throw go away, saw the ball boot away from the right fielder, and he was off to the races. And, yeah, like you said, that's just an area you can't afford to make, and that's the third error of the game on the Pacifics, which is an extremely high amount of errors. This ball bunted foul by Sergio Morando. Morando was hit by a pitch in the first, had a single in the second, flew out to left in the third, and grounded out to short. So he is 1-for-4.
What you said about the errors, they've come at really unopportune times. I mean, just it's really cost them some runs.
This bunt gets down. Both the runners will move up. They go to third, and he's safe at third, and everybody's safe. Oh, boy, what a mistake there from Lovejoy. What is he thinking?
Yeah, I mean, there was clearly no shot at getting him at third. That's just not a good decision by Lovejoy. Should have spun around and gone to first there.
Granted, they had the force on at third, so it's a little bit easier to get the run. But in this situation, when you got nobody out in an inning where you're looking to just keep them from scoring a whole bunch of runs, you want to get the shore out. And just not the case there.
Well, the Stompers offense just keeps wheeling right now. They just can't stop scoring runs.
And there's a brown ball base hit left field. One run scores. Runner at third falls down. Gets back in at third. Safe. So run comes in. It's 13-7. A little bit of a break there for the Pacifics. It should be 14. But the runner at third fell down.
Well, this inning is just endless. There's still no outs. And three runs in for the Stompers.
And the bases are still loaded. As we welcome you into our booth, I'm Jeff Safford.
Fans, this note, just to let you know,
and we're having a short conference at the mound. I'm sure this is just to waste some time so they can get their arms ready in the bullpen. Still one arm working. As the full moon tonight comes kind of climbing over the clouds. There's some high clouds this evening. It's we've mentioned a couple times, it's very humid out, and it's due to some of the monsoons and some of that that's going on south of us down in Los Angeles area, San Diego, and Arizona. This is the monsoon season for them, and a lot of times for us here in Northern California, we see some of that kind of creep into our backyards, and that's what's happened with us tonight. Definitely a lot cooler, which is definitely a good sight, I'm sure, for all the fans and players. It was in the 90s the last 2 days, and there you see the moon. Pretty good shot. Kind of an interesting moon, as you can see, kind of the just hidden with the clouds. I feel like we're in New Orleans or something, or maybe in the Midwest. It's kind of very similar to that. As the new pitcher has made his way onto the mound.
Your attention, please. Now pitching for your Pacifics, Eric Jaffe.
We've just gotten word that new pitcher is Eric Jaffe.
This call to the bullpen is brought to you by...
Yeah, it's unable to tell who's in there because these numbers 42s that we said before.
Yeah, we've been at the mercy of the people from Media Row to find out who new players are. And of course, we know things about all the players, but we don't memorize what every player looks like. So. Pretty nice crowd here this evening. And definitely just a good community feel here at the yard. You know, something for everybody here at Albert Park. It's good for kids. You got the bar down the left field line serving beer and wine. So can relax down there, have a beer or two or three. And you can get some good eats down the right field line with the concession stand with Mount Tam tri-tip and cheeseburgers and hot dogs and Louisiana hot links and all that good stuff. I want to get that.
Now batting for the Stompers, Joel Carranza.
Now here is Joel Carranza for the Pacifics.
Yeah, dangerous hitter here.
Seventh hitter this inning for the Stompers. Three runs in, bases chucked. In a 13-7 ball game, the Stompers really trying to put this one away. First pitch of the at-bat is a gnarly slider down below the knees. That thing had some heat on it, and Pacifics is definitely a strikeout situation, no doubt. Carranza is 2-for-4. He had a double and an RBI in his last at-bat in the fifth, and he smokes this one down the right field line, foul.
Well, Eric Jaffe really supplies the power. You just have to swing it.
Absolutely. Yeah, so far he's featured a hard slider and a fastball.
All right, good.
And Carranza, powerful hitter.
Okay.
Looks a little bit like B.J. Upton. He swings and grounds this one. Bates hit center field. One run scores. Two runs score easily, and it's 15-7. Another RBI, two RBIs here for Carranza in his third hit of the night. And what an offensive show put on by the Stompers here tonight. My goodness.
Now batting,
yeah, he took
Stompers,
that outside Isaac pitch the other right way and just drove it into right field past the diving reach.
Thing of beauty. Thing of beauty right there.
Infield was playing in. Not much you could do about that.
Yeah, and just a major league hang with him for the pitcher on the mound. Here's Wenrich. Wenrich is 2-for-3 tonight. Double in a center field his last at bat and scored a run in the fourth. Runners now at the corners, still nobody out. One pitch on its way. It's a swing and a miss. Fastball blew it right by him. And he throws hard. Taking his time now is Wenrich steps out. Now steps back into the box. 0-2 count. Let's see what he throws. Fastball fouled straight back. Wenrich not fooled at all. Well, I guess it doesn't take a rocket scientist to figure out what he was going to throw there either. It's like asking what pitch Rick Vaughn is going to throw.
Forget Terminator.
Forget about the curveball, Ricky. Give him the heater. 0-2 pitch. Fastball. Oh, look out. Way up high. And there's a little bit of Rick Vaughn right there. Just a hair outside, and, you know, not too far. Oh, boy. One ball, two strikes this account. 15-7 now your score. Five runs in already for the Stompers in this inning. Swing and a ground ball foul. That pitch came in on Wenrich a little bit. Surprised he didn't break his bat. He's still got his lumber.
Yeah, we're almost 3 hours into the game now, and it's still only the top of the sixth inning, so this has been a long night.
Yeah. Man. Hope you didn't have a date planned or anything like that. Those would have been way out the window by this point. Swing and a miss at a ball in the dirt. Wenrich is gone.
Well, it's good we gotten out there. I mean, first out of the inning and five runs in, so
little bit of a bit of a mock cheer from the folks here at Albert Park, just, you know, saying hallelujah. And here's Christian Gay Day. Today has two hits. He's 2 for 4 in the game. He reached on an error also in the fourth inning. Daniel Baptista, who led off this inning, is on deck. So unless G'day hits into a double play right here, we're going to go all the way around the batting order. For the third time tonight, the Stompers have done so. Pitch is way outside, 2-0.
Yeah, Eric Jaffe's been a little bit wild.
Yep. And that's been a problem for everybody tonight for the Pacifics. Control has been the one blaring issue, and just not being able to establish that fastball command. You got a lot of guys we've seen just from tonight that throw hard on this Pacifics club, but it's just been a problem of getting that ball over the strike zone. And so many, and that's so many times is the drawback on a power pitcher, is they can't command the zone. 3-0. And that pitch gets back to the backstop. Runner is going to come in to score easily from third, and it's 16-7. And this is just getting going from bad to worse. My goodness.
Well, that backstop's pretty far back. Reminds me of Odotco Coliseum, the home of the A's. I mean, there's really nothing you can do about that for the catcher Gingras.
And it's a little bit unique here because from left to right, there's almost no foul ground because of the two dugout clubs sections that are for spectators here, kind of almost close to where the normal on-deck circle would be, but definitely a cool section, I think, as Baptista is back up to the plate.
Yeah, it's a way for the fans to sit next to the players. It's pretty cool.
Baptista, this is second at bat this inning. He walked earlier in this inning. Kind of, you don't have to say that very often. And another ball misses outside, 2-0. No action in the Pacific's bullpen at the moment. 2-0 pitch. It's a swing and a ground ball to second. This could be 2-4-6-3. No, safe at first. So the Pacifics cannot induce the double play.
Well,
thankfully, it's the first place, first play in a while where a run hasn't scored. But it's been a sixth run, sixth inning here for the Stompers.
Well, although it's 16-7, though, Jeff, I mean, I wouldn't rule the Pacifics out. We thought the game was over when it was 8-1 early in the ball game. They came back to make it 9-7. So you never know.
You never know. And that's kind of the beauty of baseball. Sometimes you get weird games like this that just both offenses almost just seem to feed off of each other, as this pitch is taken low to Mark Hurley. Hurley singled earlier in the sixth. He is 2 for 4. Pitch to Hurley is swung and fouled straight over the top of us.
Thank you to our new Pacific.
And down pretty close to where the bar is set up behind us. One ball and one strike. Something we haven't even seen a lot of this inning is an even count. 1-1. Swing and a line drive, foul down the right field line.
As
that ball was smoked.
Your garbage. Feel free to say hi to Jackson Shapiro, a Syracuse Orange.
As surely two more runs would have come in to score on that one. But lucky enough for the Pacifics, that ball was fouled by about, I'd say, 2 feet.
Well, as you said earlier, there's been a lot of loud contact. No really soft pop-ups or line drives.
Swing, and there's a line drive, but hit right to the right fielder. That's Hova in right field. And that will mercifully end the inning. Six runs coming to score for the Stompers. Here in the top of the sixth, we will head to the bottom of the sixth with the Pacifics trailing now by 16-7. And now we will send it down to Milena for that last inning recap.
Estamos acá en este comienzo de la sexta entrada y un comienzo muy difícil para nosotros fanáticos de los Pacifics porque Sonoma hizo seis carreras con cuatro hits y la verdad que eso nos pone en una posición muy difícil porque los deja con 16 carreras y 16 hits, ningún error y nosotros tenemos siete carreras con seis hits. El señor está tomando mi visión, pero ustedes... me pueden escuchar muy bien y la verdad que saben que este es un momento difícil en el partido, un momento crucial y si nosotros ponemos la mente en el juego vamos a poder lograr superar este muy difícil desafío del primer partido de la temporada. Así que bueno, vamos ahora a un corte y vamos a volver con la segunda parte de la sexta entrada.
Guys, fight back. Here we go. Yeah. Oh, said, I might get that inning today. I might get out that bump today.
Are you in the
spirit?
Is it on today?
Nice job, fans. Nice job.
Yes, sir. That's Tiger.
Leading off for your Pacifics, third baseman, Adrian Martinez.
Welcome back, everybody, to the 2015 coverage of the Pacifics in the bottom of the sixth inning. Stuart Horn and Double A are back with you.
I'm excited to be back here on the TV.
Yeah, well, I'm excited that you are, too. And let's find out what's going on here for the good old San Rafael Pacifics. I can tell you one thing, Double A, 16-7 is pretty hard to swallow.
Yeah, this is kind of like the Giants when they won against the Dodgers 19-3. Kind of like that.
Yeah, it is kind of like that. In the bottom of the sixth inning here. And the chopper down the third base line. And the count is nothing at two. Who is it? We have no idea? Ah, very good. We're gonna wait. No. So all I know is that there's one out at this point.
Now batting for your Pacifics.
Certainly not David Kiriakos.
Second baseman, David Kiriakos.
Now it's Kiriakos. That was Martinez. Well, we were close. Martinez strikes out, swinging. And now David Kiriakos with one away. Well, in Double A, you know, you get a game like this as Kiriakos stands in and takes one inside. You get a game like this, and it's hard to remain interested, although the Pacifics showed early in this game they can keep coming back. But do you think they could do anything in 16-7?
Probably. Maybe they could score some runs right now in this happening.
Well, they certainly could. The question is, do you think that they will? 2-1 to Kiriakos.
There is a chance that they could.
All right. I think you're right about that. Zach Pace is on deck.
Kiriakos
is up right now. That's right. And he spins away from one that's high and tight, and it's 3-1. This game already is 3 hours old, and we're only in the bottom of the sixth inning. And Kiriakos breaks his bat, and it's up the middle. And reaching for it is Jared Mochizuki, and he boots it. And Kiriakos is aboard after an error. on Jared Mochizuki. And Mochizuki out there at shortstop usually has very sure hands. Yes, double A?
An interesting fact about Kiriakos. He was named team MVP 3 years in a row.
Well, that is very interesting. That's a good thing to be named, I would think.
In high school.
Oh, in high school. Not here on the Stompers. Zach Pace stands in with a man on and a man out. And a breaking ball is up high, 1-0. Zach Pace. Stuart Horn in double A here in the Pacifics broadcast booth. Double A is one of the young broadcasters along with Double G, who did great work tonight. His first night on the air, his maiden voyage was a total success. Next one to Zach Pace is taken. And I'm not sure what the signal was. There's no sign from the umpire. So the scoreboard reads 1-0, but there's been two pitches. Very high. And it's 2-1. I'm not sure who's working the scoreboard up there in the booth, but there have been three pitches thrown. There we go. Now they got it straight. Johnny Bakakis is on deck. Pace takes something off speed, and it's outside 3-1. Yes, double A? Well, no. You can tell us about stuff like that. You don't have to ask me. You know. So you wanted to make the point that Zach Pace has been with the Pacifics since their inaugural season.
Yeah, I wanted to make that point and state that he and another player on the team have been on the Pacifics since their inaugural season back in 2012.
Do you know who that other player was?
No.
Michael Hova. In fact, in 2012, Hoba was the league MVP and had a 37-game hitting streak. Isn't that amazing? 37 games.
That's pretty amazing.
It really is. 37 games.
How did it get broken?
He went 0-4 one night, and it was a tough night to swallow for Pacifics fans. You're doing a good job looking into that camera, I'll tell you. You're really good at that.
Thanks.
Your first night on the air. Total success. All right, Bakakis stands in, and he's behind in the count, nothing and one. Zach Pace, the runner at first base after the walk, and, of course, David Kiriakos over there at second base. 0-1 to Bakakis. First-year man of the Pacifics, and a breaking ball is taken 0-2. Matt Chavez, who had that Herculean bomb back in the first inning, is on deck. But Bakakis, who bats 280 coming into tonight's game, stands in 0-2. Two runners on, one away. Line drive into left field. That drops in front of Hurley. And he gets it in very quickly to hold Bakakis to a single. No runners can come across the plate, but everybody moves up.
First baseman, Matt Chavez.
And here's Matt Chavez. Chavez, a triple. He's got three RBIs, the home run, and I would think, double A, that if the Pacifics had any chance of getting back in this one, that Chavez might have to do something quite incredible here tonight. Hey, there we are from a different angle. Look, that camera's way, way up in the rafters. See my hand? That's weird. I don't even know where that camera is. Chavez stands in.
I know, I just moved into view and smile.
Well, that's what else can you do? 1-1 to Chavez. You know, when the camera's on you, it's just always a good idea. If you smile, you can't go wrong, right?
Right.
That's what I say.
All right, Chavez, here we
go, baby. 1-1 to Chavez. 16-7, folks. 16 hits for the Stompers. No errors. 8 hits for the good old San Rafaels, and 3 errors, and a flare down the first base line right into the glove of Baptista, 2-1.
Now batting for your Pacifics. Right,
and that's a tough little wasted bat for Matt Chavez. And here's Michael Hoba with the bases loaded. And nobody likes to be at the plate with the bases loaded more than Michael Hoba. And few people are more capable than Michael Hoba, certainly. And here he is, batting 366. And hammers one, third base line. And reaching down is Christian Gayday. And he picks it up and steps on the bag. And Hoba, on one pitch, goes down five unassisted.
If yours has been signed
and
by
we are going to the top of the seventh inning.
You just won a $25 Il Fornaio gift
when
card.
We do come back. But for now, the Spanish synopsis with our lady out on the sideline, Milena, now. Take it away.
Lamentablemente, este final de la sexta entrada no ha sido muy provechoso para nosotros, los fanáticos de los Pacifics. No tuvimos ninguna carrera y sí tuvimos dos hits, pero bueno, terminamos con 16 carreras y 16 hits para los Stompers y 7 carreras y 8 hits con 3 errores para nosotros los Pacifics. Esperamos que ojalá en estas tres, en estos tres últimos innings que quedan en el partido lo puedan dar vuelta al partido, así que ojalá esto suceda. Vamos a dar un corte y volvemos para la séptima entrada.
Hey, Pacifics fans, did you know the biggest VIPs of our team are our host families? We Pacifics rely on local families to house our players during the summer, and for their generous hospitality, the Pacifics give them a big thank you. If you're interested in becoming a host family, please go to the guest services desk for more information.
Jeff. Welcome back, everybody. Matt Hibbert here is going to lead things off in the seventh inning. Double A and I are just having a blast up here. Our first broadcast of the 2015 season. We're going to be back on July 7th for our next live broadcast on CMCM's coverage of the 2015 Pacifics. Hibbert stands in and takes a strike. 16-7 in this lopsided affair. Hibbert takes 1-1. Totally lopsided, though, double A.
Yeah. And I'm also happy that my first broadcast was a success.
Yeah, I think you're right. It has been very successful. You've been great.
And I want to owe it all to you for helping me.
Well, you're welcome. Breaking ball is in there to Hibbert. Take in a check swing, strike three.
In accordance with our contract with the city of San Rafael, we must now suspend our recorded music for the evening. But you can keep your party going right up the street.
Down looking as it was a checkout.
The Flatiron, the favorite late night haunt of your Pacifics.
One away.
Now batting for the Stompers, TJ Gavlik.
Here's TJ Gavlik, who came in double A, as you remember, when Faye Lentini was tossed. Valentini, who is the center fielder and player manager for the Stompers, a totally effective player.
Who's up?
And TJ Gavlik, the guy who's up right now, came in his place.
Gavlik.
Oh, takes, and I don't know where that missed. 1-1. We're just in the seventh inning, everybody, in this 16-7. Game. And Gavlik up the middle, and that's a base hit. Zach Pace is there. And the Stompers just keep stomping. How about that? Gavlik roped that one right up the middle.
That's a good one.
Okay, thank you.
Gavlik can play second base and third base.
Is that right? Is that what it says?
Yep.
Wow. Here's Sergio Miranda. Miranda's a couple hits, couple runs scored tonight. One away here in the top of the seventh inning. And Miranda takes a fastball low. You can see there Double A is checking her, all of her notes. And she has a binder full of stuff, which is very impressive.
Yeah, I have profiles of all of the Pacifics players listed in alphabetical order, and then the same thing with all the Stompers players in
good.
Alphabetical order.
Well, excellent work. You've really learned well. 2-0.
I have.
Yeah, I know. This one's fouled out on Anderson Drive, and thankfully no cars hit. 2-1. That's the one thing. You drive around a ballpark, and you never know. The balls all go flying out. It's not just Albert Park. It's all ballparks.
Miranda is in his first season with the Stompers.
All right, very good. And Miranda hammers one left field. And to his left is Jeremy Williams, and he lumbers over and makes the grab on a ball that looked like it was going to drop and be extra bases. And that Jeremy Williams is just so smooth out there.
Impressive catch.
It really was. I think he robbed Sergio Miranda of extra bases. So Jared Mochizuki now approaches.
I think you're right.
Well, thank you.
You're welcome.
Two down. Gavlik's still the runner at first base. And the fastball is up a little bit to Jared Mochizuki. 1-0. Joel Carranza is on deck, the DH. But for now, it's Mochizuki. Chopper into right field, and that's a base hit. Around second, a big turn by Gavlik, but then he retreats back to the second base bag. And Mochizuki has another hit for the night. He scored twice tonight.
Your attention, please.
Mochizuki's been tough on the good old San Rafael Pacifics tonight, Double A.
Andrew Parker.
Yeah, he was former teammates with the current Stompers pitcher, Matt Walker, on another team.
Do you know what team that was? Was it the Maui Nikoi Kaika? I think it was. Joel Carranza now batting.
Yeah, I think you're right.
Two on, and Carranza swings at a fastball very high. And Carranza is a big slugger. 16 RBIs and 5 home runs. 323 batter. When he connects with it, look out. I don't know where that missed. That looked really good right across the belt, but maybe a little bit outside, 1-1. Two down, two on. 16-7. Top of the seventh. Lovejoy looks the runner back. And swung on and fouled back to the screen. One ball and two strikes to big old Joel Carranza. And he's been a load against the Pacifics. Carranza seems to hit the ball often and quite sharply. Got a couple RBIs tonight and a couple runs scored, Carranza. Seems like I'm saying that about each of the Stompers players. Couple hits, couple runs scored. But all the Stompers players are hitting the ball tonight a lot.
Yeah.
They keep running, and they don't stop. And Isaac Wenrick's on deck, and he's another guy who's been doing it tonight.
With 12 hits.
A changeup gets Carranza to wave at him, and he goes down. And finally, we're ready for the seventh inning stretch. We go to the bottom of the seventh inning, and the San Rafaels have some runs to make up. A 16-7 game. It'll be Jeremy Williams, Ricky Gingras, and Danny Gonzalez will send it down to Milena now for the Spanish rap.
medio de la séptima entrada y la verdad es que los Stompers no tuvieron buen desempeño en esta mitad de entrada, no hicieron ninguna carrera, pero sí tuvieron dos hits, ningún error, y bueno, tendremos que ver cómo les va a los Pacifics en la segunda mitad de la séptima entrada. Vamos a un corte.
Nice job. But it doesn't have to be the last cold ball. Head over to the Flatiron after the game for the last call. Alcohol service will cease at the conclusion of the seventh inning. This is the Flatiron last call. Fans can vote today off the field of the Pacifics by downloading the official San Rafael Pacifics app on the iTunes App Store and the Android Marketplace. Like them on Facebook and follow them on Twitter and Instagram. Don't forget to also follow Pacifics on Snapchat with username SRPacific.
The Center Field Chamber of Commerce thanks great fans for coming out and supporting our award-winning Pacifics baseball team and the business community. You are our all stars. Let's go Pacifics!
Looking into the camera, kind of being cute all night long. She's one of our junior broadcasters along with Double G. Double G's been on tonight. He's done a great job. His maiden voyage. Jeremy stands in and a sharply hit ground ball into right field gets things started for San Rafael. Well, that's a good way to get it going there, Double A.
Yeah, it is a good way to get it started because now that there's a a home run would score and make them make them closer to 12 runs.
Yeah, it's 16-7. They got a chance. It ain't over, right?
It ain't over till it's over.
That's right. There's a fastball down the middle to Ricky Gingras, a called strike.
Didn't Yogi Berra say that?
I think Yogi Berra said something like, it ain't over till the fat lady sings. I think that was his line. There we are. I don't know where that camera is either. But they know where we are.
I think it's probably over, like, near us, but not near us. That doesn't make sense. Oh.
Well, no, I don't know where that one is either.
Probably from my side, right-hand side?
Maybe. There's only one camera I know of, and that's the one that's right here close to us. This one is fouled up and away down the third base line. Out. Oh, and it got the top of the beer garden. That's a good thing they put a roof on that thing.
Yeah, because then it could have hit somebody, and they would have yelled, "Ouch!"
They might have. Gingras stands back in. Behind in the count, 1-2. Jeremy Williams, the runner at first base. Danny Gonzalez is on deck. Gingras waves at one, and he's out on strikes. Boy, that was a power-on-power fastball. And Gingras heads back. So Danny Gonzalez now with one away and a man on. We're in the bottom of the seventh inning, everybody. And there's one of our camera people. And where was she? Double A, is she down the third base line?
I think so, maybe.
Okay, I'm not sure where she was. And this is sharply driven into right. Gonzalez gets a good piece of wood on it. And coming up with it is Hibbert out there in right field. Gonzalez with another base hit tonight. Gonzalez hitting the ball very hard. And where the outfielders are not standing, and that's a good thing if you're a Pacifics fan. Jeremy Williams advances to second base on the hit by Danny Gonzalez, and here's Adrian Martinez.
Martinez can play both catcher and first base.
Well, that's good to know.
And this is his first season with the Pacifics.
And he's starting tonight at third base. He lifts one into shallow right. Coming in on it is Hibbert, and he's got it. And an unproductive out now for San Rafael. Two away.
Kiriakos.
So the fly ball to nine, and it's on David Kiriakos. It's all up to David Kiriakos to keep this thing going. He's got two on, two down.
It's always good to a footy your notes if you need to remember something.
You're absolutely right. That's why we keep score the whole game, right?
Yeah, and that's why I have my notes right here.
All right. Fastball is a little low and in, 1-0 to Kiriakos. A 306 hitter, 19 RBIs, and two stolen bases. Kiriakos in his second year as a San Rafael Pacific.
A gold star for him.
A gold star for Kiriakos. I agree with that. He has himself a championship ring from the 2014 season.
And so do you, right?
So do I. You're absolutely right. Last year doing radio and TV, and the Pacifics were nice enough to include yours truly with a championship ring. 2-0 now to Kiriakos, and a bender in the dirt. 3-0. Conley. Who started this one. And now it's 16-7. And a fastball is pouring in. And Kiriakos taking all the way, 3-1.
Kiriakos can play second base and shortstop.
Yeah, Kiriakos is very versatile. Middle infielder, very strong arm. Theo Fightmaster in the house, always good to see him. And underhanded on a sharply driven ball to Sergio Miranda, but underhanded to the covering Jared Mochizuki at second base. And Kiriakos goes down 4-6. Well, the Pacifics made a little noise there.
Yep.
But no runs. And that will send us now to the top of the eighth inning. Isaac Wenrick, Christian Gayday, and Daniel Baptiste are coming up for the Stompers. Down to the field we go to Molina.
Muchas gracias, Stu. Y la verdad que nuevamente tenemos malas noticias porque los Pacifics no hicieron ninguna corrida, pero sí tuvieron dos hits. Esto nos deja al final de la séptima entrada con un total de 16 carreras para los Stompers y 18 hits para los Stompers sin ningún error, con 7 carreras para los Pacifics y 10 hits con 3 errores. Se ve bastante difícil poder dar vuelta al partido, pero siempre hay que intentarlo y siempre hay que poner lo mejor de uno. Así que esto nos lleva a la octava entrada del partido, que quizá nos trae buenas noticias. No podemos saber hasta que no entremos a ella. Así que así nos dejamos. Vamos a un corte.
Your attention, please. Now pitching for your Pacifics. Number 42, Zach Pace. Thank you. Pacifics, Patrick Conroy.
Welcome back to the broadcast here, everybody, here on Marin TV. Sorry, what's your full name again?
Graham Gillis.
Behind the dish appears to be Adrian Martinez.
0-1 count, Jeff Safford and Graham Gillis along with you here in the eighth inning.
We believe Tiger Peterson is in center.
Tiger Peterson has come into the game in center field to play. And Zach Pace is on the mound. And there's a swing and a high fly ball to Peterson in center, and he puts it away for the first out of the inning.
Well, Pace, the center fielder, coming in for the first time. And he looks pretty good out there, Jeff.
Yeah, no problem with that routine can of corn.
Now batting for the first out of the inning, Christian Gayday.
Here's Christian Gayday. Gayday is 2-for-5. Had a hit in the first and the second inning. It was actually his 2-for-4. He walked in his last bat in the sixth. First pitch here from Pace is up high. One ball, no strikes. And I know the crowd at this point does not look that impressive as this pitch is swung on in a high pop-up. In the infield, Gonzalez underneath, and it's actually going to be Corrales over at second base for the second out. Sergio Miranda makes the play. And Daniel Baptista will now step in. And we have something for, I believe, maybe a chance for the first time tonight. Curveball in there, strike one. As we may have our chance for the Pacifics for their first 1-2-3 inning all night. It's a swing and a Texas leaguer center field, and it is good. Diving catch made behind the bag and by.
Not sure who that is, but that's a heck of a catch. Zach Pace with a 1-2-3
eighth. What a heck of a catch made by the second baseman.
Yeah, great catch there. Just laid out completely, working his butt off there. Just fantastic.
Very nice play. And that will do it for the top of the eighth. We will head to the bottom of the eighth inning. Quick inning, 1-2-3 inning. We will send it down to Milena quickly now to recap that 1-2-3 inning.
Bueno, muchas gracias, Jeff. Esta fue una entrada de 1-2-3, una entrada simple, básica, que le dio a los Sonoma Stompers ninguna carrera, pero sí le dio unas posibilidades de correr. Así que, bueno, esto nos deja quizá la posibilidad de alcanzarlos en esta entrada y en la próxima. Tenemos una pequeña posibilidad de poder alcanzarlos, así que quizá podemos hacer uso de ella. Tenemos que verlo. El tablero está 16 runs para los Stompers, 18 hits y 17 runs para nosotros los Pacifics y 18 hits con 3 errores. Así que quizá esto mejore ahora. Habrá que ver. Vamos a un corte.
Zach Pace. Welcome back, everybody, to the broadcast here on Marin TV, Pacifics Baseball. And the pitch is to Zach Pace, is swung on and hit shallow left field, and it's going to be caught in left field by Mark Hurley for the first out of the inning.
Yeah, the now pitcher, Zach Pace, put a nice swing on that one.
Tiger Peterson.
And there have been multiple changes by both teams that we're still getting sorted out. And once we do get everything sorted out, we will let you know where who is playing where. Obviously, when you got a game like this, 16 to 7th, you see a lot of changes. Managers trying to get as many guys up to the plate as they can.
Yeah, so you can make some contributions to their team because it's a great time for players to make their debuts and see what they can do.
Because a lot of guys, until you get them in the game, you really don't know what you got. 1-0 pitch is just off the plate outside. Two balls and no strikes. Started saying earlier, the crowd is now at this point maybe doesn't look all that impressive, but you got to give credit to all the fans that have stuck around. That's knocking on 11 o'clock, as this has been an extremely long baseball game. 2-0 pitch on its way, breaking ball out in front, fooled the hitter. Barista, he's had a nice game. 3-for-3, single in his last at bat in the sixth. Hitting with one on and nobody aboard in a 9-run hole. 2-1 pitch on its way, ball misses. Up and away, 3-1.
Yeah, the Pacifics faithful have stayed here all night, and they're looking for another spark from the Pacifics.
We saw it earlier in the game. The Pacifics started the game well behind, but bounced back, cut the lead to 3 at one point, or 2 actually. It was 9-7 at one point, but then in the sixth inning, the lead ballooned back up again, and that's where we stand right now, where the Stompers scored 6 runs in the sixth inning, and we are where we stand at this moment now with the score at 16-7. 3-2. Matt Chavez is on deck. This pitch is a ball, and the scoreboard says 3-2. And for whatever reason, it is not ball 4. And the pitch is low and inside. It doesn't matter. It will still be a walk anyway.
Well, 7 runs usually wins you a ball game, or at least gets you in contention to win one. But I mean, tonight is not the case. 16 runs on 18 hits for the Stompers.
Now batting,
and we do have an update on some of the changes that the Pacifics has made. Peterson in for Bakus in center field. Conroy is in for Gringas at first base. Chavez moves to third, and Martinez is changed to catching, to the catcher. So, again, Peterson is in for Bankus in center. Conroy in for Gringas at first. Chavez moves over to third base, and Martinez is in the squat, putting down the signs. Chavez. Breaking ball misses up high. 2 balls and no strikes.
Yeah, the southpaw lefty Patrick Conroy, the Pacific's ace, is playing first base tonight. And their center fielder, Zach Pace, is now pitching.
Huh. How about that? Talk about role reversal. You got your normal leadoff center fielder pitching and your ace pitcher on at first. Sometimes these clubs, they obviously don't have as many players on the roster as a big league team would, so sometimes you just got to do what you got to do. You got to do what you got to do for your team to win. 2 balls, 1 strike. Here's the pitch. Swing and a line drive base hit center field. Just sneaks by the second baseman. Two runners aboard for the Pacifics.
Michael Hova.
Matt Chavez has done a great job tonight putting the bat on the ball and putting a nice swing on it and driving it. He has three legs of the cycle now.
And now here's Michael Hova. Hova, the righty, stands in and takes a strike on the outside corner. Hova's had the best batting average on the team coming in to today, but he has been kept quiet tonight as he is 0 for 4. 0-1 pitch is a ground ball foul down the left field line. That ball hit pretty well. Hova just a hair in front.
Stompers, people in the bullpen are all going to chase that foul ball, having a little race for it.
Yeah, they've been sitting down there for a while. They need any kind of excuse to get up. Maybe it'd stretch their legs a little bit. 0-2 on Hova. Here's the pitch to him. It's a swing and a ground ball into the hole at short. But shortstop makes the play on his second for one. Hova comes up lame, and it ends up being a double play. So a 6-4-3 double play on the play as Hova seems like he kind of stopped running. We'll have to keep an eye on him, make sure he's all right. But that is the inning as Hova, man, what a long night for him, takes an 0-for-5, and we will head to the ninth. And that means for the second to last time, we are going to send it down to the field.
Muchas gracias, Jeff. Y bueno, nuevamente sin mucho que decir al respecto de esta octava entrada. La verdad es que no hubo ninguna carrera para los Pacifics. Sí hubo un hit, pero no nos deja más cerca de alcanzar a los Sonoma Stompers. Así que las posibilidades de ganar este partido son bastante pocas, pero sin embargo hay que siempre tener esperanza. Y bueno, eso nos deja ahí muy cerca de la novena entrada, ya a punto de empezarla, pero con un tablero que dice que tenemos 16 carreras para los Stompers con 18 hits sin ningún error y 7 carreras para los Pacifics con 11 hits y 3 errores. Así que no se ve, no tenemos un futuro muy, muy genial para nosotros los fanáticos de los Pacifics. Así que bueno, habrá que ver si la novena entrada trae un milagro. Vamos a un corte.
Well, Zach Pace has made his way back out onto the mound. And, you know, it's funny, Jeff, in 4 years, I've never seen Pace pitch. And this is hammered into the right center field gap. And there's so many changes going out on all of the different position players for both teams, but mostly for the Pacifics, as that was hammered about 10 miles. And I don't know who the batter was, Jeff, because in the interim, I figured you were keeping score. You could just tell me.
That was Gay Day.
So Gay Day leads off with a tremendous blast to the base of the wall. And let's see if I got this right. I believe it's Daniel Baptista.
According to my scorecard, that's who it is.
Now the hammer on two hops, too short, and that's scooped up by Gonzalez. And 6-3 goes Daniel Baptista. Now it's TJ Gavlik, so this is the top of the order. So I'm not sure what's going on. I don't know how Mark Carlson up there in the booth has been able to keep track, because I was over on Media Row a minute ago listening to all of the different broadcasters. And everybody was completely confused. So you got Patrick Conroy over at first base. And I've never seen him play. He's in there for for Gingras.
Conroy is the pitcher, correct?
And Conroy is the superstar pitcher.
Yeah.
Over there at first. And oh, now
boy.
A long fly ball to right field. And
uh-oh.
Backing up on it is Hova. And he's right at the base of the wall. And he makes a great catch. And, you know, Zach Pace is not doing a bad job out there on the mound. I've never seen Pace pitch. He's doing nice work, actually. T.J. Gavlik rides one all the way to the fence. But
Pace not a big guy at all, but holding his own up in the mound. At least for the Pacifics, is one thing he's doing is he's throwing strikes, which has been a challenge for this staff all night long.
Sergio Miranda is the batter and takes the 0-1 delivery, and this is a little bit up and in. Actually, I thought the first one was a little bit higher, but I just figured the umpire behind home plate wants to go. That's what it seemed like. This is a long fly ball to deep center field. And to his right and making a great play is Bukakis to end things. So Miranda lets it ride, and we'll go to the bottom of the ninth inning in this one, a 16-7 game. And Jeff, you have any idea who's batting? Because I don't. I want to know who the Pacifics are sending to the plate. And if you can update me. In the meantime, we'll go to Milena and we'll have that for you when we come back. Now to the field to Milena.
Y bueno, otra vez tuvimos una gran defensiva en esta primera mitad de la última novena entrada del partido y esto nos ayudó porque la verdad es que los Sonoma Stompers no pudieron hacer absolutamente nada, se quedaron en 16 carreras y 19 hits, lo que nos deja quizá a la espera de un milagro. Vamos a un corte.
Leading off for your Pacifics, Chris DiBiase.
Well, Chris DiBiase will make a little move toward the home plate tonight here in the bottom of the ninth. First chance we've seen DiBiase as a Pacific here on Marin TV's coverage of the 2015 squad. Of course, DiBiase's played against the Pacifics all this time. The last 4 years, DiBiase's been on several different teams, and he hammers one past the outstretched arm of Christian Gayday at third, and he has a base hit. So DiBiase's aboard, and here's Patrick Conroy to bat. Wow, so Conroy, who's the ace of the pitching staff, not only getting some work in at first base, is going to get a chance to swing the bat here, Jeff, against the side-arming slinger, Sean Conroy, who's on the mound. So you got Conroy against Conroy.
Yeah.
Sean Conroy on the mound against Patrick Conroy.
Patrick Conroy, a big fella. Let's see if he can swing the bat.
And a breaking ball, and quickly Patrick Conroy's ahead in the count. 0-2.
See if he's got any mad bum in him.
Yeah, check it. It's 1-1, not 0-2. And he swings and fouls one. Yeah, it didn't look too bad. Fouls it back to the parking lot.
It looks like he deserves to have the bat in his hand.
Yeah, it was smooth.
Maybe a hair bit out in front, but
take it.
Hey.
Patrick Conroy stands in. You know, I must have seen Conroy bat some point last year, although I just don't recall him ever batting.
Well, this is a very unique game. I'm sure I won't forget him batting.
Yeah,
after
and to see Zach Pace pitching for the first time. Patrick Conroy chops one to second. It's fielded cleanly by Mochizuki. He throws to Sergio Miranda at second base. They cannot turn the double play.
How about that? Conroy beats it out.
So Conroy beats it out on the back end. So he's pretty quick.
That a babe. I give him
right.
A big tip of the cap there. A pitcher who's kind of thrown into the fire here in a blowout game that he beats it out at first base. And to me, if I'm a teammate of this guy in the Pacifics, he just gave me a heck of a lot of respect.
One away for Danny Gonzalez. Patrick Conroy, the runner at first base. Sean Conroy on the mound for the Stompers. 16-7, bottom of the ninth inning. This game is now close to 4 hours old.
Whew.
Yeah, this one's going on a while. Danny takes 2-0. Gonzalez comes into tonight with 7 RBIs, batting .280. And he hammers one foul down the third baseline, and it's 2-1. Our next telecast, everybody, will be on July 7th. So that's next Tuesday, and Jeff and I will be back. Of course, Double G will be back. Graham, one of our junior broadcasters, part of the Pacifics / Community Media Center of Marin Association, to give young people a chance to broadcast some games. And Double A, who did her excellent work tonight, her television debut, she'll be back with us. We have 6 more games after tonight, so both Double G and Double A are going to be back for most of those games. And, of course, Jeff and I will be here for all of them. And Jeff, of course, a broadcasting sensation from Dominican University. And it's fouled straight up. And giving chase is Isaac Wenrick. He can't get to it. So Danny Gonzalez is still alive.
And there's a lot of foul ground back there. And in a lot of ballparks, you wouldn't see that even looked at. But
yeah, even pro-size ballparks, there's just a ton of room here at Albert Park behind home plate. You're absolutely right. And I heard you giving props to the people who stayed. And there aren't a lot, but maybe 50 people are left in the stands tonight. All the way, this 4-hour game. 16-7. It's really been something. And there's a called strike, 2-2.
And it's a school night, too, you know. I mean, school is out of session, but you get the idea.
0-2, I should say. And I think we're back down to Adrian Martinez. And it's lunged at and foul back. So Conroy is over there. No. You know, with the numbers thing tonight has thrown me, Jeff. And by this time of the night, it's so hard to see who is where. Conroy, the runner at first base. Here in the bottom of the ninth. Martinez. A 1-2 count with 2 down.
Yeah.
And Kiriakos on deck.
Oh.
It is tough. And he hammers it back to first. Pardon me, back to the catcher. Pitcher Conroy. He underhands it to the covering Bautista. And finally, and mercifully, a 16-7 game. 16 runs on 14 hits. No errors for the visiting Stompers. 7 runs and 12 hits, with 3 errors for the Pacifics. And our next broadcast, our next telecast, I should say, will come on Tuesday, July 7th. Jeff and I will be here. But for now, the final time, we're going to send it down to Milena on the field.
Gracias, Stu. Y bueno, cuando la cámara me enfoque quizá me podrán ver, pero la verdad es que en este partido, en el primer partido de esta temporada, no tuvimos suerte. El milagro no sucedió, pero bueno, terminamos con 16 carreras para los Stompers con 19 hits, con 7 carreras y 12 hits para los Pacifics con 3 errores. Bueno, es un resultado que lo podemos esperar hacia la mitad del partido, que quizá no es el que más nos guste, pero bueno, nos estamos calentando para el resto de los partidos de la temporada. Nos vamos a ver la próxima semana. Yo soy Milena Sinosi y espero que les haya gustado el comentario en español de este partido. La semana que viene prometo que no vamos a tener tantos problemas técnicos. Y bueno, nos veremos la semana que viene. Muchas gracias.
Hey, buddy.
right, everybody. Well, our chance to sign off now after, well, if you love baseball, tonight was a nice night to be here. If you're a Pacifics fan, a little bit tough, Jeff, but 16-7. It was a one-sided affair, but, you know, it was interesting. The Stompers jumped out ahead early in this one, right out of the gate, with those four runs in the first inning, and then four more in the second.
Yep.
And what I loved is the Pacifics kept biting back, and they kept trying their best to get back into it. And, you know, it wasn't until about the sixth or seventh inning when it looked like, well, maybe they weren't going to be able to get back into it eventually. But they kept coming back, and I got to give the Pacifics props for that. And also to the fans who hung out, because this one went on for a while. This was 3 hours and 49 minutes from top to bottom. And on Dusty Baker night, on Jackie Robinson night, so Dusty was here to commemorate Jackie Robinson. All the players wore number 42, which is really tough to call a game. But it was nice to see, and they retired number 42 here at Albert Park. And I want to say thank you to our junior broadcasters, AA and Double G. They did their brilliant work tonight. Of course, Milena, who took over our new feature of synopsizing each half inning in Spanish. I like that. That was very cool. She did a great job with that. And of course, to you, your first television appearance with the Pacifics. And I thought it was a lot of fun.
Yeah, I definitely had a lot of fun, and obviously we'll look to get a little bit of a closer game next time.
Well, let's hope so. For Pacifics fans everywhere, I speak on their behalf that like to see a closer game and maybe even have the Pacifics win once we're back on television on July 7th. We hope to see everybody then, so thank you for spending your evening with us very much. And Marin TV's coverage of the 2015 Pacific. So long, everybody.
Have a good night.